Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How-To, and today I'm going to show you how to save a file for printing in Adobe Illustrator. And this will be for a small project like a flyer or a postcard. Now, before we get too far into this video, I really want you to reach out to your printer and ask them what their requirements are, because I've worked with 5 or 6 printers over my career, and they all have different requirements. Some want bleeds with no crop marks. Some want bleeds and crop marks. So you definitely need to just check with your printer and see what they want. So first I'm going to show you how to save a document with bleeds and crop marks. Now, honestly, when this gets to the printer, they'll probably just take the crop marks off, but it allows them to see exactly where this should be cut. And that way there's no question about that. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to start a new document by going to Create New. The first thing you want to do is make your artboard the size of the cut flyer or postcard. So I want this one to be 4x6. So I'll just type that in here. And since this one will have bleeds, I'm going to put my bleeds at 1/8 of an inch, and that is the standard size. So it's 0.125. And if you have this selected, it'll automatically fill in all these areas. And then we'll create. So this will give us a document. Our artboard is 4x6, and then we've got this little red area, and this out here is the bleed area. So I'm going to just paste something in that I copied from another document. So I'm going to hit Command F or Control F. So it puts it right exactly where it was on my other document. This is a 4x6 postcard that I'm wanting to add bleeds to. And as you can see, I'm just going to zoom in here. If I hit Shift O, I can see the edge of my artboard. And this comes all the way out to the edge, but it doesn't extend over to the bleed line. And if you have bleeds, you need to extend your artwork all the way over to that. So I'm just going to grab that black area. I don't want to move anything else. I just want to extend the black so that it goes all the way out to the bleeds. And I'm holding Option now so that it'll resize both ways at the same time, top and bottom, and then right and left. So now if we zoom in, nothing here has changed. This is the same distance to the edge, but I just extended the black out to the bleeds. And by the way, I got this postcard from vecteezy.com. Anyway, we're ready to save as a PDF now. So I'm going to come up here to File, Save As, and I'll just choose PDF right down here. I'm going to call it Halloween Postcard with Bleed, and it'll have PDF at the end because I chose that here, and I'll save. Now here's where we'll set up the bleeds and crop marks. So we'll just come right over here to mark some bleeds. I'm going to make sure this is checked. Use Document Bleed Settings. If you uncheck it, you can input whatever you want. So you can manually do it that way. Or you can just click this button if you've already set up your document bleeds. And we also want trim marks. That'll give us crop marks. And we'll say Save PDF. Now if we come out here and look at our PDF, I'm just going to hit Command O or Control O to open that. You can see we have our crop marks and bleeds now. So they can cut right along this line and then cut along that line and still have plenty of area down here and on the sides to mess up if they don't get the cut exactly right. Now I'm going to go back to my Illustrator document, and some printing places don't want crop marks, but they do want bleeds. So let's make one like that. We've got our document opened up and we've got the background extending all the way to the bleed line. Now we'll just do Save As, which is Shift Command S or Shift Control S. And I'm just going to call this one Halloween Postcard, and I'll call this Bleeds Only. We'll save as PDF. And now the only difference is we don't want trim marks. So I'll uncheck that. We'll continue to use the document bleed settings, and we'll save PDF. Now let's go and look at what this one looks like. This one goes all the way out to the edge, and if we hover down here, you can see it's 4.25 by 6.25. That's including that bleed of 0.125 on both the right and the left sides and the top and the bottom. That's where the 0.25 comes from. If we look at our other one, this size is kind of a random size, and that's because it's including this white space out here. But once this is cut, if they use the crop marks and make a perfect cut, it'll be 4x6. The last thing I want to show you is if you don't have bleeds at all. So that means that nothing is printing up to that edge or going off the edge. So in that case, you're going to want no crops or bleeds probably. You'll want to check with your printer on that too. So let's open one that doesn't have something going off the edge. Okay, this is a good example. We don't have any color that's being printed up to the edge or off the edge. All the way around, it's white. So in this case, we would want to save as like we did before, and we'll change our file type down here to PDF. Then I'll hit save. Then we'll come down here to marks and bleeds. Make sure neither one of these things are checked, and then we can save PDF. Now I do want to mention, if you want really good quality, you can change your Adobe PDF preset here. I like to use either Illustrator default, high quality print, or press quality. So once you hit that, like let's choose press quality, then I'll come here to marks and bleeds, make sure nothing is checked, and I'll save PDF. And now when we open this one in Acrobat, we can hover down here and you can see that it's exactly 4x6. So if you don't need bleeds or crops, your final size will end up exactly the size as your document itself, unless your printer wants you to add those for some reason. Now, if you have a front and back to your postcard or flyer, you're going to have two pages in your PDF. So you'll have a page here, and then you'll have another page that's exactly the same size with the same setup. So if one of them has crops and bleeds, your other one will have crops and bleeds, and one will be the front and one will be the back. So that's how to save your document, if it's just a small print piece, for printing. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.